Doctor, Mr. Osborne's here.
Nobel Prize, Otto, Nobel Prize. We'll all be rich.
Yeah, it's not about the prizes, Harry.
But you need money, you need Oscorp.
Who do we have here?
This is my good friend I called you about. The guy who got me through high school science.
Peter Parker, sir.
Parker?
I'm writing a paper on you for...
Yes, I know what you're doing here, but I really don't have time to talk to students right now. But Oscorp pays the bills, so...
That's right. That's why I have to take off, board meeting. But my job is done here. Got you two geniuses together. Good luck tomorrow, Otto.
Nobel Prize. We'll see you in Sweden!
Interesting fellow, your friend.
Well, it won't take much of your time.
Parker, now I remember you. You're Connor's student. Tells me you're brilliant. He also tells me you're lazy.
I'm trying to do better.
Well, being brilliant's not enough, young man. You have to work hard. Intelligence is not a privilege, it's a gift. And you use it for the good of mankind.
Otto, your lunch is ready.
This is my wife, Rosie.
Hello.
This is Peter Parker, Connor's student, the one who falls asleep in class.
I always fell asleep in physics class. Nice to meet you, Peter.
Good to meet you.
Excuse me.
Is that it?
Yes. My design for initiating and sustaining fusion.
Well, I understand you use harmonics of atomic frequencies.
Sympathetic frequencies.
Harmonic reinforcement?
Go on.
An exponential increase in energy output.
A huge amount of energy. Like a perpetual sun providing renewable power for the whole world.
It's also amazing. If it works, it could change the way we live.
It is amazing, and it will work.
Are you sure you could stabilize the fusion reaction?
Peter, what have we been talking about for the last hour and a half? This is my life's work. I certainly know the consequences of the slightest miscalculation.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to question you.
Rosie, our new friend thinks I'm gonna blow up the city. You can sleep soundly tonight.
Otto's done his homework. Come to the demonstration tomorrow and you'll see for yourself. You need to sleep soundly tonight, Otto.
Did Edison sleep before he turned on the light? Did Marconi sleep before he turned on the radio? Did Beethoven sleep before he wrote the fifth?
Did Bernoulli sleep before he found the curves of quickest descent?
Oh, Rosie, I love this boy.
Peter, tell us about yourself. Do you have a girlfriend?
Well, I don't really know.
Well, shouldn't you know? Who would know?
Well, leave him alone. Maybe it's a secret love.
Love should never be a secret. If you keep something as complicated as love stored up inside, it can make you sick. I finally got lucky in love.
We both did. But it's hardly perfect. You have to work at it. I met him on the college steps and I knew it wasn't going to be easy. He was studying science and I was studying English literature.
That's right. I was trying to explain the theory of relativity. Mm-hmm. And Rosie was trying to explain T.S. Eliot. Time present and time past are both perhaps present in time future. I still don't understand what he was talking about.
Oh, come on.
I'm serious. T.S. Eliot is more complicated than advanced science. But if you want to get a woman to fall in love with you, feed her poetry.
Poetry.
Never fails.